Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamu alaikum. And guys, I welcome you. Although it would sound strange to you guys because last time we had one-on-one interaction here in Qasim Ali Shah Foundation, but still I am talking to you from the same platform and we are going to have a wonderful class today. I will try my level best to give you a feeling as if you are attending this class right in front of me. Okay, so be attentive, and one more thing, you can just grab your favorite drink. Like my favorite drink is water, and you can see I've got water with me, so you can grab any juice, any cup of tea or anything like that, and you are going to have fun and enjoy this class as well. Well guys, actually let me tell you, learning should never stop. Because now these days, you know, there is a ban on gatherings and classes, physical classes and all that. So learning should never stop. On campus, if not possible, then online. Learning should go on. That is very, very important. So during this class, you guys can ask me questions as well. Let me just elaborate few points to you. And then after that, if you have any questions, you can ask me and we will go on. And this session is going to be as interactive as we used to have our sessions in the past here in Qasim Ali Shah Foundation, right? So I hope you would be happy to see me here on screen as well. And I can see some of you as well, but most of you, your cameras are actually not working. So that's all right, no problem. I can still visualize you guys because we had a great time. We already attended a couple of sessions, so I can actually visualize you also. Anyways, today we are going to take a start with some basic rules of English language, and I'm going to teach you three basic tenses. What happened last time when we had a class, I noticed some of you were using wrong tenses in your presentation. If you remember your last presentation, huh? Instead of present, some used past. In the past, some were using present and all that, right? So I'm actually going to just take care of this today. Right, and I will see that you don't do any mistakes which are related to tenses and all that. Anyways, let's take a start. First of all, we will talk about present simple tense. And by the way, I'm going to involve you as well, and you will have to participate. And in order to participate, you will have to raise your hand. Okay, not physically, but there is one option here in Zoom where you can click and then we will see your hand. And by raising your hand, you guys are going to actually participate. Okay, so let's go on. Present simple tense. Now remember, in present simple tense, you will use first form of the verb, the end. I'm not going to teach you grammar. Okay, I tell you again, I'm not going to teach you any grammar. I'm just going to tell you how to use these type of structures and all that. As I said today, for present tense, we are going to learn, or we are going to use first form of the verb. Now let's see where to use first form of the verb and how to make sentences and all that. First of all, whenever you guys talk about your daily routines, whatever you do every day, every month, every week, on the daily basis, for that you are going to use present simple tense. For example, if I say, I brush my teeth every day, I'm holding a brush and I say, I brush my teeth every day. What is that? That is my daily routine. So whenever I am going to talk about my daily routine, I am going to use first form of the verb. I brush my teeth every day. Some of you might say, I brush my teeth after a month, okay? Alright, it depends, okay, it's your life. I don't blame you for that. Some people don't like brushing their teeth. They have strange philosophies. They say lions and tigers never brush their teeth. So we are lions and tigers, okay, so don't worry about that. Anyways, let's just move on. Okay, so you will talk about some things which you do on daily basis, weekly basis. Now, if I say, every Friday I go to the mosque to offer my Friday prayer. Now, what is that? That is my weekly routine. If I say, every Sunday I go for shopping. Every day, every Friday, every Sunday, and even I can say, every month I pay my utility bills, okay? Every month. Now, again, focus one thing, I am using first form of the verb throughout when I'm talking. So every Sunday, I wake up late in the morning. Every month, I go for shopping, something like that, okay? Now, I'm going to come to you one by one. You just have to raise your hand and we'll give you the mic and you are going to make some sentences which are related to your daily routine, weekly routine, monthly routine, or the yearly routine. Now, please, you can raise your hands and I'm going to listen to your sentences. No one is raising hands. Come on, guys. This is so bad, huh? I will come out of your mobile devices if you don't raise your hands. Come along, someone. Please raise your hand. Yes, I see two hands. Komal Sajjad. All right. So now, Komal Sajjad, please, you can make your sentences.
I do exercise daily.
Very good. Fantastic. Afifa Ashraf. Yes, Afifa. Come on.
Yes, sir. Assalamu alaikum.
Wa alaikum assalam.
I can brush your teeth daily.
Okay, that's right. I don't use can. Simply say, I brush my teeth every day. Okay, that's lovely. And Shan, come on, Shan, it's your turn.
I used to go outside nowadays.
Okay, now Shan, instead of saying, I used to go outside, simply say, I go outside nowadays. I go outside nowadays. Okay?
Yes,
all
sir.
Right. All right. Thank you. Ariz Hassan, please.
I used to play cricket daily in the evening.
Okay. Now, again, you're saying I used to play cricket daily in the evening. Simply say, I play cricket in the evening every day. Something like this. Okay? All right. Let's go on. We've got Rahimullah, please. Your turn.
Am I audible, sir?
Yes, why not?
Sir, usually I get up early in the morning around about 6 o'clock. Then after that, I make evolution and pray offer. And usually I keep on exercise for 1 hour. And after that,
okay.
I tip the...
That's fantastic. So, Rahimullah, you said actually I used to. So, don't use used to. Simply, you can use first form of the verb. Then it is gonna be fine. Okay, Zishan Atta, it's your turn, please. Wow, I'm so glad to see your hands now.
I write articles on different topics every day.
Fantastic, Zishan. That's very good. Zishan Zia, it's your turn.
Walaikum
assalam. Yes, Zishan Atta, please, you can make sentences.
Yes, sir. Sir, I play football in the evening every day.
Okay, that's fantastic. Very good. All right, guys. So I'll take one or two participants more randomly. Muhammad Umar, please, it's your turn.
Assalamu alaikum, sir.
Walaikum assalam. Yes, please.
Sir, I learn a lot of things from my daily life.
Okay, fantastic. That's absolutely right. Okay, guys, thank you very much. Now we just move on. So this is how you can actually use first form of the verb and you can talk about the things which you do every day. Now, this time we are going to use the same tense and we are going to talk about some actions. Now, I tell you how. You know, we've got habits and we've got hobbies as well. So if you want to talk about your habits or hobbies, for that also you can use present simple tense. For example, if I say, I always get up early in the morning. What is this? This is my habit. So in order to talk about my habit, I will use present simple tense. If I say, I go for a walk every evening. Now, when I say I go for a walk every evening, this is my habit. If I say I offer my prayers regularly, this is my habit. So now I'm going to come to you one by one and you are going to tell me your minimum two habits. Minimum two good habits, okay? So raise your hands once again. Don't be afraid. I will not bite you, okay? Just don't be afraid and raise your hand. And this time you're going to tell me your two good habits. Let's talk about that. And you can use I usually. I usually obey my parents. That's a habit. I read a book before going to bed. That's a habit. So please raise your hands. I want to see your hands now. Only two hands up. Come on. All right. So I'm just going to check it. Okay, so we've got few hands now. Umme Habiba, please first you. Umme Habiba.
Assalamu alaikum, sir.
Wa alaikum assalam. Yes, Umme Habiba, please.
I listen to Islamic lectures during my I listen to Islamic lectures with my meal every day.
Okay, that's fantastic. One more. I said two good habits. Okay. All right, let's move on. Umar Hayat, please.
Assalamu alaikum.
Wa alaikum assalam. Yes, Umar.
I like to write something in my spare time.
Okay, I like to write something in my spare time. Very good. Ali Hasnain.
I read Dawn News every afternoon.
Very
and
good.
I make a video for YouTube every day.
All right, you are the one who makes videos for YouTube, huh? Would you not like to tell us about your YouTube channel for publicity, huh?
Yes.
Okay, that's fantastic. Very good. All right.
So that's Spear Academy.
Good. So guys, it's really nice to interact with you online. I mean, this is still very good. I'm enjoying it, huh? Hopefully you must be enjoying this thing as well. All right, I've got few more hands. Shahabuddin. Shahabuddin from UAT, please.
Yeah, okay, sir. My sentence is I drink 5 cups of tea every day.
Oh my God, 5 cups of tea every day, huh? You are what we call tea addict, huh? Okay. Now, those cups are empty or like tea inside?
Tea inside, yes.
Okay, that's fantastic. Muhammad Usman.
Assalamu alaikum, sir.
Okay, walaikum assalam. Yes, Aris, please tell me about your two good habits.
Sir, I didn't know it whether it's good or not, but I like to make TikTok videos.
Okay, now don't say I didn't know. You should say I don't know, but I like to make TikTok videos. Now, well, let me tell you, it depends on the content. If the content is good, it's very good. If the content is not good, then it is bad, huh? So it does not depend on TikTok. It depends on your content, whatever you're making. All right, we have Muhammad Usman. Muhammad Usman, come on. All right.
I write my gratitude journal.
Okay, that's good, Usman.
I write my gratitude journal daily.
Okay, second.
I prepare my to-do list for the next day every night.
Okay, that's fantastic. Very well. So guys, thank you. Now let's just move on, right? This was the second use of present simple tense. And keep in mind, we are actually focusing present simple tense. Now let's go on. After this, I would like to teach you the past tense, right? Now, let me just tell you, in the past tense, you are going to use second form of the verb. What is second form of the verb? You know, we say go, went, gone, do, did, done, eat, ate, eaten. So second form of the verb is actually used when we use past tense. Now, what is past? You want to talk about something that took place in the time that is gone now. Now, for example, right now it's 3:20 p.m. So I came to Qasim Ali Shah Foundation at 2:45. This is past tense. I came. Came is past tense. Today I woke up at 11 o'clock, for example. Today I had lunch at 1 p.m. I had lunch. Had is second form of the verb. Okay, so whenever you want to talk about anything that took place in the past, whether that past is today morning or that past is centuries ago. For example, you can just say, many years ago, Qaid-e-Azam Muhammad Ali Jinnah Rahmatullah Alayh gifted us Pakistan. Many years ago, past tense, right? So in the same way, whenever you talk about something that happened today morning, that happened yesterday, 1 week ago, 1 month ago, 1 year ago, or even 1 century ago, for that you will be using the past tense. Now, I'm going to come to you and you're going to tell me few things you did yesterday. For example, you can say, yesterday I met my friends. Yesterday I got up early in the morning. Yesterday I finished my assignment. Yesterday I went to meet my colleagues, something like that. So please, now you can raise your hands and make some sentences with yesterday I did this, yesterday I did that. All right, let's start. Ali Hasnain, please, first you.
Yes, sir. So yesterday I bought shoes from my brother.
All right, congratulations. You bought shoes for your brother yesterday. Bahut bahut mubarak ho, okay? All right, that's good. Let's go on. We've got Muhammad Umar.
Yesterday, I took my first online class.
All right, yesterday I attended my first online class will be better. Instead of took, you can say I attended. That will be better, right? Please, your turn. Hafiza Maida Kamar.
Yesterday, I start a book.
No, I start a book is, yeah. Yesterday, I started a book. Or yesterday, I started to read a new book. That will be better. I started to read a new book. That will be much better. Okay, you can just say that. All right, let's go on. After that, we've got Komal Sajjad, please.
Yesterday, I went to bazaar and I bought a new dress.
All right, congratulations. Okay, you bought a new dress. Very good. That's amazing. Zishan Zia, please, your turn.
Yesterday, I went to a marriage ceremony.
Okay, yesterday I went to a marriage ceremony, or it's better to say yesterday I went to attend a wedding. Wedding is more appropriate word than marriage ceremony. That's very good. Rafiullah, please.
I did bicep game in the morning today.
Okay, that's right. Hafsa Mubashir, please.
Assalamu alaikum, sir.
Walaikum assalam. Yes, Hafsa.
I started teaching when I was 17.
Okay, mashallah, that's awesome. Umar Hayat, please.
Yesterday, I went to interview a librarian.
Okay, yesterday I went to attend an interview for the post of librarian, something like that, okay? All right, guys, now let's just go on a little, and this time we are going to discuss future tense, which is very, very simple and easy. So, as far as this future tense is concerned, remember, whenever something that is going to happen in the coming time, we call it future. For example, at 6 o'clock, I will go back home, right? At 6 o'clock, I will go back home means 6 o'clock is going to be a time in future and I'm going to perform some action there. So at 6 o'clock, I will go back home. In the same way, I can say tomorrow, I will conduct my IELTS classes. Tomorrow, I will conduct my IELTS classes. Next month, I will celebrate my birthday. I will celebrate my birthday, and next month is actually future. So you can use will and first form of the verb. Now I will come to you, and this time you guys are going to share your goals, your aims with me. For example, one day I will go to a foreign country for higher education. Or you can say, one day I will establish my own company. One day I will fulfill all my dreams. Okay, so I'll come to you now, and you have to tell me your strong desires, your aim. For example, you can say, one day I will go to perform Umrah, or by the grace of Almighty Allah, Inshallah, I will perform Hajj, something like that. Okay, now please raise your hands once again, and then you are going to make some sentences. Minahil Arzu, please, you can start.
One day I will achieve my goals.
Good.
Assalamu alaikum, sir.
Wa alaikum assalam. Yes, Bilal.
One day I will join Pak Army as an officer.
Very good. As an officer, huh? Captain, then major. And then I'm going to be proud of you, inshallah.
Inshallah, sir. Thank you.
Very good. Now let's go on Ali Hasnan. Ali Hasnan, we are going to unmute you so you can please speak.
With the blessings of Allah, I will become a CSP officer in 2026.
Inshallah, inshallah. Then I will come to your office to have a cup of tea with you. Okay?
Sure, sir.
Yeah, go. Exactly. Yeah, you're laughing, huh? All right. Muhammad Amir, please, it's your turn.
In the future, I will become a multimillionaire, inshallah.
Inshallah, ta'ala. Multimillionaire. No, you should say billionaire. Million has no value now. हाँ 40-50 लाख का आजकल कुछ नहीं आता बिलियनियर मल्टी बिलियनियर
डॉलर सर
यह डॉलर इज बेटर ओके यह देन यू विल ऑल द टाइम मल्टीप्लाई विद 167 168 एंड ऑल दैट दैट्स ऑसम वेरी गुड ओके लेट्स मूव ऑन मिनाहिल आरजू प्लीज वी गिव यू द माइक प्लीज यू कैन नाउ स्पीक मिनाहिल आरजू
One day I will fulfill the desires of my mother, inshallah.
Inshallah, why not? That's awesome. Very good.
Assalamu alaikum, sir.
Wa alaikum assalam. Yes, please.
Sir, I'm writing a letter and I will publish it soon.
Okay, you are writing a letter and you will publish that letter soon or what?
Sir, I'm writing an article.
Article is better. Okay, that's very good. Fine. Okay, guys, so these are three main tenses. I just give you a recap of these three tenses. Present simple, whatever you do on daily basis, weekly basis, monthly basis, whenever you want to talk about repeated action. Repeated action is we go to mosque 5 times a day. Muslims offer prayers 5 times a day. This is repeated action. For repeated action, for hobbies, for habits, for daily routines, we always use first form of the verb. Okay. Secondly, past tense, second form of the verb. Whenever we want to talk about something that happened in the past, like that happened yesterday, last week, last month, last year. So for that, you would use past simple tense. And then we've got future simple. You use future simple whenever you want to talk about something that you will do in the coming time. For that, you will be using future simple. Now, I'm just going to ask you few questions and some of you are going to reply, right? You can just raise hand when you want to answer the question. My first question is, what do you do on Sunday? So you will answer on Sunday, I, and then go on. And for this, you will use present tense. So please now raise your hands. What do you do on Sunday? That's the question.
On Sunday, I am going to play cricket.
No, this is present continuous. Instead of that, it's better to say on Sunday, because what I'm asking you, this is what you do every Sunday. I'm not talking about coming Sunday. I'm talking about every Sunday. For example, you can say, well, on Sunday, I play cricket and I play 2 to 3 matches. After that, I come back home and I have my lunch. In the evening, I read some books, something like that. Okay, so talk about every Sunday. I mean, you will talk about the things which you do every Sunday. Okay, let's go on. Ariz Hassan.
As our vacations are going, every day feels like Sunday. So that's easy for us to carry on our daily routine as of other days.
Ariz, you did not understand my question. Just focus the things which you do on Sundays. I understand you've got holidays and you every day is Sunday, but still you need to focus some of the things which you do on Sunday. Like you can say, on Sunday, I have a wonderful breakfast with my family. We arrange a big breakfast and all my family members enjoy this breakfast. Something like that. Just talk about the things which you repeatedly do on Sunday. Yes, Ariz, come again.
On Sunday, I like to play snooker with my friends.
Okay, you can do better things than that, huh? Playing snooker. Okay, that's good. Komal.
It's a good indoor game.
I understand. It's a very good indoor game. Yeah, why not? I appreciate that, huh? Even Candy Crush is good indoor game for the people who play that. Don't try to do it, okay? Yeah, I mean, time should be spent in some productive activity. So at the end of playing snooker, you don't get anything out of it. You play Candy Crush. Now they say I am on 1000 stage of Candy Crush. So that's of no use. If you say I've got $2 billion in Candy Crush, that is of no use. So you should focus something productive, okay?
Sir, I take a part in tournaments whenever a tournament occurs. And
good.
I usually have some prize.
All right. So one day you are going to become international snooker player. And then I will say, you know, Ariz Hassan, international snooker player, he is my student. Huh? We will be proud of you. Okay, that's great. That's awesome. Komal Sajjad, please, it's your turn.
On every Sunday, I do cooking, I spend time with my family, and I do laundry.
Okay, you do cooking, you spend time with your family, and you do laundry. All right, that's very good. Umme Habiba, please, it's your turn.
I order breakfast from outside every Sunday.
Okay, this is good, but you can make 2 to 3 sentences together. Mohammed Amir.
On Sundays, I sleep until 4 o'clock.
Wow, you sleep until 4 p.m. So you are Shah Rukh Khan, huh? You sleep a lot. Okay, the film stars always sleep a lot. Okay, Shan, it's your turn, please.
Every Sunday, I used to play cards with my friends. Also, I meet up with my close friend as well.
Okay, so don't use used to. Simply say, every Sunday, I play cards with my friends. Right, like that. Minahil Arzu, please, it's your turn.
I usually wake up late on Sunday. Wake up late on Sunday.
Yeah, that's right. I usually wake up late on Sunday, and then after that, just try to make 2 to 3 sentences together.
I usually spend my Sunday with my family.
All right. Fiza Fatima, please unmute your mic.
Yes, every Sunday, I plan for upcoming week and I maintain my room.
Okay. Umar Hayat.
On Sunday, I watch a season and practice to learn graphic designing.
Okay, that's right. You're sitting in a noisy place, Umar. Anyways, that's fine. Now, let's go on. This time, you guys are going to share something related to past. Anything, like you visited a place. So you will tell me, last year, I went to Murray with my friends. We had a great fun over there. We stayed in Murray for 3 to 4 days and I really enjoyed there. The weather was awesome and we had a great time. So talk about something, a place that you visited. In 4 or 5 sentences, you will talk about that place. Okay, now once again, please raise your hands. And I can see only 4 or 5 participants are actually participating actively and others are just sleeping. I can understand that, huh? We have hidden cameras. So we can see you all from hidden cameras. ये जो लेटे हुए ना उठ के बैठ जाएं, मुझे नजर आ रहा है अभी. और ये जो बहुत पीछे टेक लगा के बैठे हैं, ये भी एक्टिव हो जाएं जरा. मुझे सब नजर आ रहा है. Okay, we've got the hidden cameras here. Yeah, तगड़े होके बैठ जाएं. Yeah, we can see everything. I'm telling you. Okay, yeah. देखा ना, मैं समझ आ जाती हूँ. जो लेटा हुआ था, उठ गया, अब हंस रहा है वो. Okay, so you should be active. Active होके बैठना है. रजाई में बैठ के क्लास नहीं लेनी. ओके, एग्जैक्टली. अभी जिस स्टेट ऑफ माइंड में जाएंगे, लेटेंगे तो एनर्जी लेवल भी लेट जाएगा. बी एक्टिव एंड अलर्ट. सो गाइज, नाउ यू आर गोइंग टू टेल मी अबाउट अ प्लेस विच यू विजिटेड. जस्ट टॉक अबाउट अ प्लेस. फिजा फातिमा, आई एम गिविंग यू द माइक, कम ऑन.
And I also want to say that I used to eat a lot of chips when I was younger, but now I try to eat more healthy.
Hafiza Maida Kamar, please.
Last year, I visited to Umar Hayat Haveli in Chiniot. It has very good interior.
Okay, that's good. So just try to connect 4 or 5 sentences together quickly. Actively and quickly. ऐसे तो मुझे नींद आ जाएगी, हाँ. Just try to connect 4 to 5 sentences together. Okay, that's fine. Now I move on. Rahimullah, please. It's your turn.
Sir, when we were in Cadet College, sir, so we have been there for 5 years in Waziristan, sir. So we used to visit it there. It is a hilly area and more beautiful and attractive area. The people are more civilized and hospitable people. So we were enjoy with them over there, and we were interactive with them when we came out of the colleges and visited every mostly in the evening. So they were the most enjoyable place. Okay. Anyone want to visit, they can visit.
Okay, so Rahimullah, just try to focus the past tense and use second form of the verb to describe that. Okay, that'll be better. Ali Hasnan.
Yes, sir. Last year, I went to Islamabad with my besties, Faisal Mosque. We did a lot of fun, made TikTok videos and prank with the people of Islamabad. And it was a lot of enjoyment and recreation.
Okay, you pranked people of Islamabad. How did you come back after that, huh? If you pranked those people in Islamabad, there are big rajas and rajas will never let you come back, huh? Tusan sade na prank karde ho thanu hune dasne, huh? They never spare you after a prank. Okay, that's right. That's great. Okay, let's take a couple of participants and then we move on. And guys, your attendance will be marked on the participation of your presentation. If you remember, I gave you a task that you would have a motivational presentation. So those who are going to appear in motivational presentation, their attendance will be marked. हमें यहाँ पे number नहीं चाहिए. I don't want to see over here that everyone is present. I will just see who is participating. So the ones who are participating, their attendance will be marked, and those who are not participating, they will get show cause notice. Why did you not participate? So please be active and alert. And you remember that I said you will give a motivational presentation, and that presentation should motivate us as well, right? Okay, so let's just go on towards that, and you can just prepare yourselves. I mean, I just give you a few seconds to get ready, and those who are already prepared, I will give you 1.5 minutes. Right, for this presentation, and then you will just finish it. And remember, when you deliver this motivational presentation, your words, your voice, they really play important role. Although I cannot see your body language, your facial expressions, but through your words and voice, I mean, you are just going to speak actively and energetically. That will play a role, right? So let's just take a start in few seconds. So we are going to take a start with the presentations, and again I tell you, on the behalf of your presentation, we will mark your attendance. I have this stopwatch with me. You guys can see the stopwatch, right? It will start running, and I will give you 90 seconds for each presentation, right? Let's take a start. So we've got Ariz Hassan. Ariz, please, you can start your presentation.
Sir, can you give me two minutes more.
Really? 2 minutes में क्या पहाड़ गिरा लोगे भाई? जो 15 दिन में नहीं हो सका, हाँ? I gave you this presentation 15 days ago and still you need 2 minutes. चले देखते हैं 2 minutes के बाद कौन सा बम गिरता है. Okay, I give you 2 minutes. Right? Don't worry. Let's go on. Bilal Hassan, please. It's your turn. Bilal Hassan. वालेकुम अस्सलाम जी. बिलाल माशाल्लाह बहुत अच्छा बच्चा है जी, ये तो हमेशा तैयार होता है. ये है बिलाल?
थैंक यू सर.
वेरी गुड. सो बिलाल, यू कैन स्टार्ट नाउ. ओवर टू यू.
अस्सलाम वालेकुम माय रिस्पेक्टेड टीचर एंड स्टूडेंट्स. टुडे दिस इज बिलाल हसन. टुडे आई वांट टू गिव यू अ मोटिवेशन लेक्चर. इट्स रियली गिव यू मोटिवेशन. यू नो our life is very short. It is too short. So I just wanna say, dream big. Don't give a break. Keep working hard. It's okay if someone is laughing at you. It's okay if someone is pulling your leg, pulling your back. It's okay. You just keep working hard. You just keep looking up the sky and reach your goals, no matter what anyone else says. Because if you cannot protect yourself and dream for yourself, nobody else can.
Okay, that's fantastic. Thank you very much. This is very good, Bilal. Thoda sa awaz mein garam joshi leke aaye. You should be a little more energetic, because you know, motivational speakers energize the audience, and that is only possible when you yourself are energetic. So that's gonna be fine. But I really appreciate that you started well, and you started it very well. So it's going to be good for others as well. Thank you. After Bilal Hassan, let's move on to Ali Hassan. Ali, aajo maidan mein.
Yes, sir. Sir, today's my topic of this topic of motivation is hard work versus luck. Sir, most of our youth depend on the luck. They thought that they have a shortcut and luck, they will be successful and rich. So I am here to tell you that it's not a good criteria or good opportunity to become successful. Because there is no substitute of hard work. We have to work hard to polish our skills to become professional. Then we will be able to become successful. In the Quran, Allah has clearly mentioned, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, وَلَيْسَ لِلْإِنسَانِ إِلَّا مَا سَى. Translation, and nothing is for man but what he strives for. So Allah has clearly said that if you work hard, I will give you reward. So why don't you work hard? So I will also quote a quotation that Jeffrey Thompson said, the harder you work, the more lucky you are. So if you work hard, then you will be lucky. Then you will be able to get opportunities, to get chances, to show your skills. If you don't work hard, you don't have skills, you don't be a master in your field, then you will not be become successful. If we observe the biography of all the successful person in the world, like Ronaldo, Messi, Imran Khan, Shahid Afridi, even Sir Qasim Ali Shah and Asa Yaqub sir, they all are hard worker, not luckier. So we should work hard instead of depending on the luck, because there is no substitute of hard work. Without working hard, we will not become successful and rich in our life.
Okay, that's fantastic. Ali, overall, it's very good. But I would like to advise you that you should slow down. Why you need to slow down? Because, you know, the listeners, they have their listening capacity. They receive your message, they actually interpret your words, and then they understand. So overall, your words were really good, but you just need to slow down. Like, you know, now I am talking to you, I'm not very fast. If I say hard work is really the key to success, those who work hard, they achieve a lot in their life, something like that. So slow down and just have a feeling that I am conveying my message to the audience and they are receiving my message. So if you are faster than the capacity of your audience, they will not understand, things will fly over their head. So overall, it was good. Just focus the delivery style and it's going to be wonderful.
Okay, sir. So I was thinking about the time management, that's why.
Don't worry. But you spoke well. You really spoke well.
Thank you, sir.
Okay, let's go on. Fiza Fatima, please.
Assalamualaikum.
Wa alaikum assalam. Yes, Fiza, over to you, please.
Today, I share my thoughts about life. Life is a continuous ongoing process that has to end someday. Life is all about adoring yourself, creating yourself. A quote for you that life can be only understood that way, but it can be lived forward. Life itself is a golden opportunity to live a meaningful life and support others. It doesn't matter how many years you live, but it matters how well you live a quality life. The fear of death always threatens our life. Every person has to face death, sooner or later. But that doesn't mean it should be discouraged from living life to the fullest or achieving our goals. A person is wise only when he or she is ready to meet destiny when it comes. But until that time, enjoy every bit of it. Is a sense of readiness. It is a journey in everyone's life wherein we have to cross the bridge of death to be able to wake up to the life of death. Lastly, I will conclude that we should make life worthwhile. It should be with the love of our family and friends. That life can be made beautiful. Life can be more beautiful and purposeful
Okay. All right. Thank you very much. You spoke for 1 minute 31 seconds. So Fiza, overall, it's quite good. Just try to focus the delivery, because I realize that you are communicating word by word. I mean, after each word, there is a very little pause and then you move on to next word. Try to communicate sentence by sentence. For example, if I say I want to drink a glass of water, I am communicating word by word. But if I say I want to drink a glass of water, so this is a fluent sentence. So you need to focus fluency. And on the other hand, your overall style, it looks like you are reading something. So it should not be a reading style, it should be a conversational style where you are conveying a message, where you are trying to communicate something to your audience. So just focus these things, overall it is fine. Let's go on. After Fiza Fatima, we have Zeeshan Zia.
Assalamu alaikum, sir.
Wa alaikum
assalam. My name is Zeeshan Zia. The topic of motivation that I am discussing today is about donations, sadaqah. I think donation is an act that plays an important role in our lives, as it is one of the 5 pillars of Islam. As Muslims, we should practice this act and try to help poor and needy. Some of us might think that donating might cause decrease in their money or wealth, but that is not the case. It is promised by Allah that if you donate in His name, He will definitely increase your wealth. Try to donate.
Yeah, good.
An issue that we face is that whom should we donate? I'll specifically talk about beggars. without whether they are the right ones to donate. Some of them are and some of them are not. It's difficult for us to differentiate. But due to this equality, let's not stop donating. Keep donating by keeping your eyes open to differentiate. Even if we donate to wrong person unknowingly, I think that should not affect our virtue. We are donating for Allah. Even if we are being deceived by someone, then there is possibility that at the day of the judgment, at least we can say to Allah that, Ya Allah, I was deceived in your name. I was donating in your name. Let me say this in Urdu. Roze akhir hum kam az kam ye to keh sakte hain ki Ya Allah hum tere naam pe lute hain. Jazakallah.
All right, mashallah, that's very good. 1 minute, 37 seconds. Overall, it's good. And the way you presented it expressed feelings and emotions as well. And the final sentence that you quoted, so that was all good. So, you know, good presentation is a presentation where you express your feelings and emotions as well. Like you were talking about sadqa and khairat, charity and all that. So most definitely you needed to adopt a tone which is more humble, polite. So this is very good. Keep it up like this. And I could feel your emotions as well. This is an integral part of good communication, that your feelings and emotions also get across. That's very good. Thank you very much. Let's move on to Luqman Khan, please.
Assalamu alaikum, sir.
Wa alaikum assalam. Yes, Luqman, please, you can start.
Sir, today my motivation speech is about what actually life is. We live once routine of a day for some 5 years and we call it life. No, that's not life. If you are still thinking why you have been sent here, if you are still juggling with the concept of why you are here, you haven't lived yet. You work hard, you make money, you do it for yourself. That's not life. Go out, you seek for the people who need your help to make their lives better. You become the spongy which can absorb all the negativity. You become the person who can emit beautiful, positive vibes. And when you realize that you have changed someone's life, and because of you, this person didn't give up, that is the day when you need happiness. Thank you.
Okay, that's good. You finished early, like you finished in 50 seconds, but overall it was good. Still, I had a feeling that you were reading it from somewhere. So try to adopt a natural communication style where you are trying to convince the people. You know, communication is all about convincing the people whatever you are telling them. So when you have that convincing style, this is the same style like, you know, when we have to convince our parents. We just say, mommy, please buy me that pair of shoes. Mom, I like it very much, please. So that convincing style should be the part of your active communication. So instead of the reading style, just come towards the natural speaking style. And for that, I advise you to watch some English programs, to watch some newscasters on BBC, CNN, Fox News. That will actually help you a lot. But overall, it's good. So keep it up, Luqman. Let's move on. Thank you very much. Umme Habiba, please.
Assalamu alaikum, everyone. Today, I'm going to tell you something very much different. As we all know that the last month was the month of independence. So I am here to question you all that what is independence in your view? Like only doing these haunts and doing awkward things, and even the girls cannot even go outside. So if we ponder over our history, we see that how many lives were given in this way, how our ancestors, our women, our children, our forefathers gave their lives for this land. What was the purpose of this independence? Have we forgotten this? So Lord Mountbatten said that if he had known that Qaid-e-Azam was having TB, then he would currently have been then there was no Pakistan, but we came to know that how Qaid-e-Azam worked really hard, how everyone gave their lives. Why? Because of the purpose they had, because of the two nation theory. Although we are having our same culture, same food, same spices, but one thing that discriminate us was the theory that is Pakistan means La ilaha illallah. So I advise and I request everyone to know our real purpose of this independence and to be on the right path again, to practice the purpose that is La ilaha illallah and to know our purpose and to know our real thing that is the worship of Allah in the
Okay, all right. Thank you very much. You spoke for 1 minute 40 seconds. And Umme Habiba, overall, it's quite good. Although there was some noise coming along, but overall it was good. So keep it up. And if you're doing it live, maintain good eye contact with the audience. And as you are just speaking, like, you know, I mean, when you speak, there are some feelings which you express. So throughout your presentation, I focused one thing, that there was the monotone. Monotone means the same tone throughout the presentation. Try to have the variations. Sometimes your voice should go up, sometimes it can come down, like you say. And you guys know the way Qaid Azam Muhammad Ali Jinnah Rahmatullah Alayh made Pakistan for us. We should be proud of him. On the other hand, we cannot ignore the sacrifices. See that variety of tones, and this variety actually entertains your audience. So audience must be entertained through your words, through your voice, through your body language. So this is what you need to focus, but overall it's quite good. Let's go on. We've got Abdul Jalil, please.
Assalamu alaikum.
Wa alaikum assalam. Abdul Jalil, please, over to you.
Yes, sir. Today I'll discuss about the importance of belief. A belief is a feeling of absolute certainty. If you want to achieve anything in life, you need to get certain and you will achieve it. You must believe in yourself. You will never take actions towards something you don't believe is possible. You can have all the education in the world. It doesn't matter. If you don't believe you can do it, you will never get it. The great entrepreneurs, the great human beings are great because they believe in themselves. They believe when no one else does. They believe when they are down, because beliefs control your results. In order to succeed, you must believe. In order to succeed, you must believe. In order to believe, you are good enough. And if you aren't there yet, get to work. Work on your weaknesses until they become your strength. Work on your flaws until they became your fire. Work on your problems until they became your power. You will win, not immediately, but definitely. Just believe in yourself. Thank you.
Okay,
sir.
That's fantastic. Very good. Quite motivational, huh? Like Shabazz Sharif. Okay, when he's addressing the audience. Keep it up like this. Overall, it's very good. I really appreciate that. Although there were some grammatical mistakes and there were few mistakes related to pronunciation, but overall your expression was good, and for a motivational speech this was ideal. So keep it up like this and try to listen to some more motivational speakers. Like you can listen to Mr. Qasim Ali Shah, then you can listen to some international motivational speakers along with him, so that you understand how to deliver, or how do motivational speakers deliver in English. So if you have good communication skills, whether you do motivational speeches or you do other lectures related to your studies, you will always be regarded highly among the people. So overall it's good. Abdul Jalil, keep it up like this. Thank you. All right, let's go on. Shehroz Ali, please, it's your turn.
In the name of Allah, the most beneficial and the most merciful. Assalamu alaikum, everyone.
Walaikum assalam.
This is Shehroz Ali. Today, I will tell you that God has a plan for you. Sometimes you need to get knocked down before you can really figure out what your fight is and how you need to fight it. Sometimes you need to feel the pain and sting of defeat to activate the real passion and purpose that God predestined inside of you. God says, I know the plans I have for you, plans to hope and future. This day, when you have reached the hilltop and you are deciding on next jobs, careers, further education, you would rather find purpose is an essential element of you. Remember, the struggles along the way are only meant to shape you for your purpose. When God has something for you, it doesn't matter who stands against it. If it's meant for you, then God will move someone that holding you back away from a door and put there someone who will open it for you. I don't know what your future is, but if you are willing to take the harder way, the more complicated one, the one with more failures at first than successes, my only advice is that press on with pride and press on with purpose and appreciate what God has brought you through. Thank you so much.
That's fantastic, Shahroz. Overall, it's very good and your expression was good. Fluency was there. Again, I would say just try to focus ups and downs actually. You know, sometimes you go to the lower tone. Sometimes you raise your voice high. So this raising of the voice and going down, this is how you can amuse your audience. So try to use it further. But overall, it's quite good. I mean, you spoke fluently, you spoke clearly. I understood everything that you said. So just keep it up like this, okay?
Okay, sir. Thank you.
That's great. Let's go on. Mohammed Usman, please.
Assalamu alaikum. My name is Mohammed Usman and my topic is focus on your future. This is short motivational will give you the inspirational to focus forward on what you want because your future is waiting for you. What's ahead of you is a big, bold, bright and amazing future. Just go and get it. The only thing stopping you is worry, fear or doubt. You may be too focused heavily on what you don't have instead of what you have to do. Just focus forward. You cannot get what you want by focusing on you don't have. You want great health, but you keep talking and thinking about your bad back. You want great relationships, but you keep complaining about the bad ones. You want money, but you keep complaining about being broke. You want a great and amazing life, but you're focused on not having it. The best way to bridge this gap between what you have and what you want is appreciation and gratitude. So just believe in yourself and remember that your future is waiting for you. Just focus on your future. Thank you.
Okay, that's fantastic. 1 minute and 12 seconds, but overall it's good. Usman, just try to do a couple of things. The first thing is fluency. For this, I would advise you for 10 minutes a day or 15 minutes a day on your mobile, you can just watch BBC News, the headlines. When you watch BBC News, the headlines, you'll be very clear the delivery, their overall style and everything. And second, you just need to focus the fluency as you are expressing yourself. You should be fluent. Now, fluency does not mean that you have to speak very fast. It means there should be a continuity. I mean, just a flow, a rhythm of your speech or rhythm of your talk. So these two things you need to just do and observe international motivational speakers, observe different news channels which are in English. That will help you a lot. I mean, I can see potential in you. All right, thank you very much. After Usman UET, we have Komal Sajjad. Yes,
my Komal. Sir, Komal Sajjad. And my topic is use of social platforms. As we know, everything has benefits and drawbacks. On the very first presentation about routines, most of my fellows told that they spend most of the time on social platforms. Using social site is not a bad, but using it all the time is the bad habit. Instead of learning informative things, we all are busy in liking, comment on other productive skills. We need to produce our own things on which people may appreciate us. Instead of using YouTube for watching movies, songs, use it for learning IT programs or other skills that can help us in future. Watching movies isn't a bad, but watching it all the day and the late night is bad. Mobile phone is very productive thing, but using it in a positive way, we can become a successful, but its usage may destroy our lives. In the COVID pandemic, people spend their time in learning for good future. And on the other hand, some people are using it for more watching movies, series, etc. Thank you.
Okay, that's great. 1 minute and 20 seconds. Komal, I would appreciate you. Overall, your delivery was quite energetic. So, I mean, you've got energy in your voice, okay? This is really awesome. Just focus one thing. When you deliver a sentence, try to deliver it in one go. One go means there should not be any pause or any break when you are delivering a sentence. Like, for example, if I say, I would like to talk to you about a couple of things. I didn't take any break. If I say, I would like to talk to you about a couple of things, I'm taking a break. So just try to go on fluently. Although, I mean, you can be slow, sometimes you can be fast, but there should be the proper rhythm of your talk, which is important. But energy is good. I mean, there is potential. So just go on, and observation, observing other speakers, how they speak, will improve your English and your presentation skills quite a lot. Okay.
Thank you, sir.
Okay. Thank you very much. Let's go on. We've got Muhammad Umar, please.
Today I talk about the students who face a lot of challenges when he enters the university and in educational institute. As a student, we face a lot of challenges and exam criteria. We have to prove ourselves to the people are living around us and our relatives and the educational institute. You have to prove that on the demand of the educational institute and many more things. You still continue your hard working. Because nothing is impossible for a willing heart. Men are crown creature. Man can be destroyed, defeated, but not be destroyed. Hurdles come into being in your life, but it does not mean your destination path is wrong. Rampart make you strong and motivate you. Keep concentrate on your dreams. Dreams are very important in the way of destination. So be consistent on your work and the student become very successful in their educational institute.
Okay, that's good. 1 minute. And Umar, overall, it's quite fine. But I would say for a motivational lecture, you just need to slow down a little, number one. Number two, I found some grammatical mistakes, and there were some mistakes related to pronunciation. Like you said, creature. The right word is creature. Instead of creature, you can use the word creature. So focus your pronunciation, and listening is the best way to do that. And there are few grammatical mistakes, so try to listen to English as much as possible. That will influence your accent, your pronunciation, even your fluency, right? But overall, it's good. And for motivational speaking, you need to slow down a little. Usman from UET, please, you can start.
Today's presentation is about importance of your circle. Let's suppose you buy a water bottle. If you buy it from a supermarket, a water bottle in supermarket worth 30 rupees. In a good restaurant, it worth 50 rupees, and at airport, maybe it cost 100 rupees. The bottle is same, the product and brand too. The only thing that changes is the place. Each place gives a different value to the same thing or same product. When you feel zero, you are worthless. When everyone around you despises you and gave you negative vibes, change places, don't stay there. Your circle defines you and your future. If you hung out with losers, one day you will become the biggest losers among all of them. You will give up every single thing you dreamt about, and good people who really appreciate your worth, don't settle for.
Okay, your voice is gone. Usman UET, your mic is mute. Yes, please. So you want to say some more?
Sorry, completed.
Okay, that's good. Very right. Overall, it's quite good. Just keep it up like this. And I would still say, like, you should focus your pronunciation. And you know, there is one more thing, especially when you are doing a prepared presentation. For prepared presentation, it is very important that you understand what you are speaking. Sometimes, you know, this happens, we don't focus on the meaning and we only focus on reading and delivery of that. So if you understand what you speak, most definitely you will add some feelings and emotions to that. So you just work out those things, and again, through observation, you can improve yourself. So overall, it's good, and keep it up like that, okay?
Sir Haseeb Khan, UET.
Haseeb Khan, UET. Okay, please, Haseeb.
Sir, today's the topic of my discussion presentation is to educate the children. It is really sad that a nation that does not invest in its children does not have a future. And it is said right. It is doomed because without a good and strong foundation, its future looks bleak. It is doomed because it never laid a firm foundation for its future generation. As the famous author John Richardson said, when it comes to the future, there are three kinds of people. Those who let it happen, those who make it happen, and those who wonder what happened. I just want to say the educators, parents, and school managements and school governing bodies that your contribution is valuable and significant for the future of the children. I urge them to continue to play a positive role towards making sure that the children receive the best education ever and that they receive it under favorable conditions. As the author said, men often become what they believe themselves to be. If I believe I cannot do something, it makes me incapable of doing it. But when I believe I can, then I acquire the ability to do it even if I didn't have the ability in the beginning. I know you have the ability and passion to make a difference. Let's together build a caring society for the better life for all.
Okay, that's fantastic. Overall, the message is good. And the way you used language, contractions, didn't and all that, that's all awesome. So keep it up like this. And I would advise you to listen to some international motivational speakers, follow their style, listen to some English newscasters, follow their style, and inshallah, you will become a very good international speaker.
Inshallah, sir. Inshallah. Thank you, sir.
That's great. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Okay, guys. So let's go on. Umar, it's your turn. Over to you.
Here's a motivational speech that I have to deliver. First of all, if you want to achieve your goal, it's not easy. That's the first thing you need to know. You want your dream life, you want the big house, all it takes is a promise that I won't stop. 5 years of pushing yourself, 5 years of evolving you, your life, and your mind. 5 years of society telling you that you can't. That's all it takes. The road to success is not easy. It is not fun, and it is not without sacrifice. But it is simple that I won't stop. Not till I make my millions, and not till I have conquered my mountain, and not till I lead the life I deserve. Every day you have 24 hours to move on one step closer to your dream. That's it. That's all you have to do. A single step every day. When you make that promise, you have to keep that promise yourself. People call it transformation. They are wrong. It's evolution. You adapt, you improve, and you grow. And one day, you will be sitting into your conquered mountain and be grateful that you made a three-word promise to yourself, I won't stop. Thank you so much, sir.
Okay, that's brilliant. That's awesome, huh? I was enjoying your presentation and it really motivated me. I am moved from inside. Excellent. Keep it up. Very good. So, you know, you have the ability, mashallah. Keep it up like this and try to go on and try to deliver some motivational talks in your university with your friends. You can do something like that. It is going to help you further and develop your skills in Urdu as well as in English, both. Because, you know, sometimes you speak Urdu, sometimes you speak English. So it's going to be fantastic. Okay, who is the next one?
Assalamu alaikum, sir.
Walaikum assalam. Yes, please.
Sir, my name is Ariz Hassan.
Ali Hassan, right?
Ariz Hassan.
Ariz, okay. Ariz Hassan. Very good. So, Ariz, over to you, please.
Assalamu alaikum, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Ariz Hassan, and the topic I'm to deliver in my presentation is patience. Patience is basically a very important thing in a man's success. Patience is important. Because whenever a person is in a situation when he cannot speak his problem with anyone, he has to be patient at that time. And honestly, Ladies and gentlemen, it's my own experience that if we are patient in our difficult time, Allah Almighty surely reward us with the success, with the thing we want. Because Allah Almighty already said that in Quran Kareem, فَاسْبِرُوا إِنَّ اللَّهَ مَسَّابِرِينَ, and be patient, indeed Allah is with the patient. And ladies and gentlemen, my dear fellows, we all are youngsters. We have a great living example in front of us. And I'm talking about the man, none other than our great Prime Minister, Mr. Imran Khan. Ladies and gentlemen, this man proved that if a man is patient, if a man is struggling, if a man is hardworking, he can achieve his goal. And he has proved by his struggle of 22 long years, that he can achieve his goal. And Allah Almighty blessed him with the success.
Okay, all right. That's very good, Ariz Hassan. I really appreciate that. Keep it up like this. Overall, it's good. Just try to focus a little more on your delivery style. Add some more feelings and emotions to your voice and you'll be fantastic. One thing. Second, I advise you, whenever you go for public speaking, you should not discuss your political views. Right? I mean, you can talk about Imran Khan. I don't mind. That's perfectly fine. But you know, sometimes people, they have their political preferences. So it's a good idea not to speak about politics in public. Okay? Otherwise, overall, it's good. And keep it up like this.
Thank you.
Assalamualaikum, sir.
Wa alaikum assalam. Your good name, please?
This is Kashif Bashir.
Kashif Bashir. Okay, just a second, please. Kashif Bashir. All right, Kashif, so over to you, and then I will come to the next one. Yes, Kashif.
Everyone, assalamu alaikum, and today I choose a topic about to deliver the power of positive thinking. If I define the power of positive thinking, what is the power of positive thinking? I think a power of positive thinking is just a mental and emotional attitude. And when people have this attitude, and they are always confident, and they will always overcome and face any hardships. Because we know, we all accept that problems and difficulties will always be there in our life. But when we deal with them with a positive attitude, we get more stronger. And this is strength. This is strength help us to achieve our goals in a good way. And I think it's just all about us and all about our mindset. If we think, if we train ourselves to look everything in a life with a positive attitude, then we can say that life is not bad as people think. Then just at last, I'll mention a quote from Thomas Jefferson. He said that nothing can help a man with the right mental attitude from achieving his goals. But also nothing on earth can help man with the wrong mental attitude. That's all.
Okay, it's fantastic. 1:24. I just found few grammatical mistakes, but that's okay. Gradually you can overcome that and try to focus your pronunciation, as we did some listening activities in our class. So these activities will help you, and focus a little more on your fluency. And by the way, Kashif, fluency comes through repetition. When you speak repeatedly, when you speak English repeatedly on different occasions, most definitely you're going to be fluent in the language. So overall, it's good. Keep it up like this, and one day you'll become a great speaker, okay?
Thank you, sir.
Asad Ali, please, you can start now.
Today, I will talk why 2% people succeed while 98% of them don't. If I talk about success, the first rule of the success is to have a vision. If you have never a vision or a goal, you drift around and never end up anywhere. But when you have a vision or goal, everything becomes easy. Visualize your vision and make it fun, and you will enjoy it. Have a clear vision what you are going to do. Today, I will tell you two rules of the success. Rule number one is have a vision. And rule number two is don't listen to the naysayers. Whenever people said you, it cannot be done, you should hear it that it can be done. And whenever people say you that it is impossible, you should say that it is possible. Once Nelson Mandela said, which was the president of South Africa, everything is always possible until someone does it. Show people by doing impossible things possible. Thank you.
Okay, that's good. 1 minute and 4 seconds. Overall good. I found few mistakes, like you were talking about Nelson Mandela and you said which was the president of Africa and all that. So who was actually? For people, we don't use which, we use who. But above all, it was fine. Just focus your presentation skills, like your pronunciation, the delivery of your method. And again, I tell you, no monotone. There should be a variety. When you speak, ups and downs of voice, they are very, very important, right? So that's good. Keep it up like this. Thank you. Rahimullah, please, it's your turn.
Starting with the name of Allah, who is the Lord of Lord and King of King, hardworking. Hardworking is the key to world success. All those who succeeded, who are and who will be, it's because of the hardworking. And that's why Allah says, all those who are working hard definitely are the friend of Allah. So for that, you will have to come out of the comfort zone, the zone where you have no trouble, obstacles, hurdles, and where you are dependent on your friends, relatives, your friends. So you will have to come out of that zones, because you will have to get the success. So for that, you will have to do work. And how much are you talented, where are you from, and where are you belong to, it doesn't matter, because the success believe and matter on the hard working. You can take the example of Nelson Mandela, who kept on the prisoner for more than 27 years, but he didn't give up. He kept on hardworking, and at the last he won because of the hardworking thing. And you may take another example of the Obama. In 1995, he was standing in a school and told her friend that I would be the president of America. He was laughing at him as usually doing in our society, but he kept on struggling. At the end, he became the president, not for once time, for twice of the America. So that's why I'm suggesting you people, no matter how much are you talented, how much are you you precious and God gifted, but you will have to do hard working, because this world based on the materialism. So for that, you will have to be hard worker.
Okay, that's fantastic. Rahimullah, very good. Keep it up like this. You spoke very fluently, very actively and very energetically. I really appreciate that. And because you spoke well, so I'm going to give you a biscuit from here. Here you go, Rahimullah. This biscuit is for you. Whenever you come to foundation, you can just receive it. Okay, that's fantastic.
Okay, thank you.
Yeah, so guys, you understand what I mean. We are going to take a break for around 10 minutes. And after the break, we will go on. So you're most welcome to have tea or biscuits at your home, right? Go and drink some tea, juice, coffee or anything. And right after 10 minutes, we will continue with the class. Thank you very much.